when it comes to exponential success, this is something that always all organizations look for. There is not much charm in arithmetical progression as a success measure or even a geometrical progression. Exponential progression is when you are looking at a number raised to the power of n. For example, 2 to the power of 2, 2 to the power of 3 or whatever. Is it truly possible? That's a question which people keep always asking me in many of the sessions that I do. While it's possible or not possible is a choice, I leave it to them because I don't want to interfere in their belief system. I only give them certain insights for them to think as to how to make it possible. There lies my answer that yes, it is possible. It's up to them to execute. I always tell them, other than the normal C-suite positions that you have, the CXOs as they call, I always tell them you must have, specifically if you are a mid-cap to a large organization, there are 3 C-suite executives you must surely have for you to really leapfrog and look at exponential success. Let us see what they are quickly. The first is what I call as a CEO. Not the normal chief executive officer that you may be familiar with, but this one is a dedicated person at the top of the management, what I call as chief excellence officer. What would be his role? For that, we need to understand what is excellence in the first place. Excellence, in my view, I define it like this. Excellence is your ability to meet or exceed everyone's expectations all the time. A very simple, straightforward definition, but in terms of execution, it really calls for quite a lot of strategy and execution. Of course, a dedicated CEO, Chief Excellence Officer, is something that every organization must surely consider having. It does pay off in the long run, big time, let me tell you. Based on whatever experience I have in having this implemented with fair amount of success in a few organizations. The second one is what I would call as a CIO, surely not Chief Information Officer. I'm talking about here Chief Integration Officer. Integrate what? Integrate the people. The rise or fall of any organization is purely dependent on the compounding effect of how well people work together. The more they work together, the better for the organization. But in this world where short-term success takes precedence over everything else, do people even have time to think about their own people? Or are they seeing them as commodities or just a P&L item? When you start looking at helping them to integrate, when you have a full-fledged person whose only job is to ensure the way in which the role of a doctor is to ensure that all organs integrate well and then work for the overall health of the body. The chief integration officer's role is to ensure that people, irrespective of where they are positioned in the organization, are able to work seamlessly together, setting aside the prejudices, egos, titles, designations for a common cause. An ideal situation? Of course, yes. Is it possible? Surely yes. It does happen in small organizations very easily, automatically, but the moment the organizations grow big, it doesn't happen. After all, the families from which we have grown, we have seen that integration is what is holding us back. Yet, what is stopping us from implementing this simple success formula in a corporate life? The third one is what I call as a CMO, surely not a chief meditation, or rather a chief marketing officer. I'm talking about a chief meditation officer. Today, worldwide, it has been proven repeatedly that periodical breaks for meditation is something which helps a lot in improving productivity, reducing stress, reducing health-related issues, dependency on a mutual relationship with other fellow beings who work along with us. I have seen many airports. I have seen many organizations where they have a designated prayer room or a meditation room. That is a good beginning, but would that be sufficient is a question that the top level management team will have to ask. A chief meditation officer would in some way work and help the chief integration officer's work becoming easier. When CMO and CIO work together, the chief meditation officer and the chief integration officer, they work together and integrate the chief excellence officer's role, which ensures that your P&L and balance sheet, which is still an item that every organization wishes and strives towards achieving, also becomes an automatic effect of all these efforts, concerted efforts put together. Something worth thinking about? Please do till we meet again in the next edition of Coffee Time Success Nuggets. This is Prakash signing off. Thank you.